I'm Sachin, and today I'm going to give you a talk on my theory of sports and how it applies to UW. Before I start my talk, let me state my position on giving this talk. Let me give a disclaimer. I'm not an Olympic athlete. I'm not the kind of athletes whose name you'll find on the screens list. I'm a recreational athlete who has been able to achieve most of his goals in individual events or team sports. So I believe I'm qualified to give a good talk on this subject since I've read up on different sports and tried to apply them to my training. So let me start. So I come from India. So India is not as developed as the US. So we don't have so many resources or so many sports in our universities. If you compare the number of sports that are available at UW to my university in India, the IITs, you'll just find 1/3 of the number of sports you'll find at UW at my university. Here you'll find basketball, football, water polo, ultimate, badminton, tennis, squash, then you find triathlon, running, swimming. You find a lot of sports. And so before I start my continue with my talk, let me classify all these sports into three buckets. So if you have a lot of covericials, it helps to classify them according to size so that you know how to use them. Okay. So here I would like to classify this big set of sports into three buckets so that I can talk about them easily. So the first kind of sports I would say is team sports, which is football, basketball, or ultimate or water polo. Second kind of sports, badminton, tennis, or squash, which are the racket sports. And the third bucket is the sports which are accessible to anyone, which are easily accessible, like running, triathlon, or swimming. Okay, these are the three classifications according to me. So it helps to classify sports because each of these have different needs, different expectations from the athletes. So this is how I would classify sports. Now, let me move on to the ingredients needed to succeed at sports. According to me, there are six ingredients needed to succeed at sports. The first is fitness, the second one is endurance, the third one is skills, the fourth one is motivation, the fifth one is teamwork, okay? And the sixth one is maybe strength. So let me start, let me go deep into each of these six factors. So let me start with fitness. So fitness is the refers to the aerobic capacity, the current aerobic capacity. So scientifically, it's given by the amount of oxygen your body can consume per second or so. So if you have one of these fancy watches, like the ones were manufactured by Garmin, if you go down a few dials, you can see your VO2 max there. So that's a number which gives you an indication of your aerobic fitness. Mine says 56, which is superior or the top 5%. And this gives you an indication of your current fitness. So this can die down in a period of 6 weeks or so. So fitness is short, it's a short-lived factor. Okay, then comes endurance, which is similar to fitness, but it's much longer lived. Once you develop your endurance, it's the same as the aerobic capacity, but just over a much longer duration. So, and the third is skills. Skills is like how well you can move your body parts to play the sport, or how well you can coordinate your eye and the hand. Suppose you're playing badminton, you may be able to see the shuttle coming over here, but unless you can reach up to it and hit it, there's no point. Okay? So skills helps you do it correctly. Then comes strength. Strength is the like amount of lean mass you have in your body. It is developed by training and it stays on your body. So skills and strength, they are also long lived, just like endurance. Then comes teamwork and motivation, which are mental attributes of the athlete, which can be promoted by other athletes or fellow athletes or your coach. And these are also short lived, but they are mental attributes. So the first two, fitness, first one, the fitness, short-lived, and these two mental attributes are short-lived, but endurance, skills, or strength, they are much long-lived. Okay, so these are the different ingredients, and For each sport, you need to make a different cake with the same ingredients. So at each counter, you have a different guy standing and you have the same ingredients and you need to make a different cake for each guy. So let me illustrate with the help of a few examples how this can be done. So let me take the first factor, which is fitness. So you may be training for a half marathon, say. So you train like 5 to 6 times a week. So your fitness, aerobic fitness develops. And suppose you want to play badminton at the same time. Badminton requires you to train 3-4 times a week with one day allocated to fitness. But if you are training for a half marathon at the same time, you don't need to allocate that day for badminton fitness. So how to be the superman who can excel all these sports? So as you can see, all the sports, they have overlapping factors. If you consider the triathlon, they have running, swimming in common. So if you are training for something, a running sport or swimming sport, you don't need to focus on that specific triathlon. Or if you are training for water polo match and so your strength develops, so then you don't need to work out for your badminton regime. So that gets taken care of. Okay. Or yeah, that's how things work. It's just like your course, so you need to manage the time well so that you can send it wisely and access sports. So I run out of examples. Whatever I said is immaterial. This is just impromptu talk I'm giving for this audition. So no matter whatever I said, Seattle or UW is a great place to play sports. So let us make the best use of this opportunity and do well.